Oh my gosh, this is my favorite part. No! I forgot about that level, bro. So this Enbernic handheld is probably one of my favorite handhelds that I've gotten. There's tons of different consoles, there's tons of different platforms, and there's also a bunch of different themes that you can choose from. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna hit this little select button at the home menu, and then there's gonna be theme one, theme two, and then there's a bunch of different styles that you can choose from. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and hit style two really quickly. And I'm going to show you what that looks like. And then I'm also going to go to style 3. And I will show you what that looks like. And then I'm going to go down to style 1. This is my favorite one. And I'm just going to continue to use this. So there's a couple of things that I would like to clear up with this little handheld console before we go into all of the games, all of the consoles, how you get into the settings, as far as like the build quality of it and all of that kind of stuff. The games you do not have to download. Can you download more games and put them on it? Yes, you can. So what you see here is a TF. This is a little SD card. And that is where all the games and images are on this thing. Now, it does have a volume up button. It has a power button, two different triggers. The audio sounds really good. It charges with USB-C and it is touchscreen. So, like you can adjust the brightness of your screen. Pretty much all like the types of Android settings that you're familiar with on your phone and that kind of stuff is what this is going to offer. Now, I do want to make it clear that not every single game that you're going to expect. I'm going to use Super Nintendo as an example here. Like Mario is not on this, at least from what I can find. And then another thing that I noticed is this right here. So as you can see, like the first, like I want to say probably like maybe 30 or 40 games, like the image on the actual handheld changes. But then you get like further into them, and I'm going to show you here with this as well. So what you see here is go down. So this one doesn't even have images as an example. So it's not that big of a deal. Obviously you're going to be more interested in actually playing the games, but you can kind of see here how all these games have images. But I guarantee you that if we, okay, this one has them all. So let's go PS1 as an example. So this one I know isn't going to do it. So you see right here, I was playing Crash Bandicoot. It runs fine on this. And then it also has God of War, which I was super surprised about. Where it is, it isn't. Oh no, that's for PS2. So this has PS2. So it has Nintendo 64. It runs fine on this. But again, the same thing. I don't know why it doesn't have any Mario games. But I'm going to show you, these are what it has for Nintendo 64 games, CPS3, little Capcom consoles, MAME. There is, I don't know how many we gotta go in. So there's 23 games. Now as far as duplicates, that is what I like about this little guy right here, is because there's not very many duplicates. There's not as many games as you get on like the like this thing over here. Like if we use this console as an example, there's literally like 100,000 games on this guy right here. Oh, or like even like this handheld, which we're gonna do a review on next. This one doesn't have the theme like this one. It's very, very, very basic, but it's still a cool little handheld. And this one, like size comparison, I mean, it's literally like half the size. But so anyways, what I was gonna say here is, God of War, my mind never shuts off. So God of War 2, PS2, so it does slow down in like the combat. I want to say it drops to, I want to say like 20 frames per sec. It's definitely playable, and you can of course adjust the settings like to like improve the performance and stuff. But it does need to be noted that as far as like, you know, slow down, you are going to start seeing slowdown with stuff like PS2, and you're not going to be able to like up the quality. But the PS2 is a pretty hard console to run as far as emulation goes, and all the other ones on this run fine. PSP runs fine, Nintendo DS runs fine, Wii runs fine. There's not very many Wii games, but you know, I don't know why they chose to like put certain games on this and then not have other ones. You would think that like one of the more popular games like Mario or Super Mario for the Super Nintendo as an example would actually be on this, and it's not even on the Nintendo either. And I'm guessing that this is for Nintendo reasons. I'm sure that most of you are pretty familiar with how Nintendo acts towards this stuff, so I'm guessing that that's why. But as far as like Nintendo and NES, this one actually, okay, yeah, you see how it stops with the images. But overall, man, I recommend this thing. This is awesome. So another thing is, I think it's start. Oops, hold on. So I'm going to go back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit back. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go, I forget how you do it. Maybe it's both. So there is a way that you get into the RetroArch settings. I don't have the manual out, so I can't. All right, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to load up a game and I'm going to show you, because. All right, and you can run background game. All right, yeah, so you hit start and select when you're actually in the game, and that brings up the menu for all, like, if you want to like adjust the settings and up them, add different filters and all of that kind of stuff, you can definitely do that. And then another thing that I had to do specifically with the Genesis, just because so also you can, yeah, I'm going to show you guys all the settings here so that you can just get an idea of what it looks like. So the main menu, you got your settings, you got your playlists, and then I'm going to go ahead and Super Nintendo, NES, Sega Genesis, Nintendo, none of these. I didn't have to go into the setting and add any like latency reduction, like with what I showed you with that PS5 emulation console, the one I showed you a second ago, this little stick, the Nintendo PC console that we made a video on. So like a lot of those like actual consoles that have Bluetooth remotes, you have to like adjust the latency inside of them because the Bluetooth remotes that they come with are so cheap. But this is built into this actual, and this is a very premium, like you can just tell by it being in your hands that it's literally made, it's heavy. And as far as like the sticks, they feel okay for a handheld. They're not like perfect, but you can't really expect that with a handheld. The buttons feel really, really this is the best handheld that I've ever gotten. So this is the box that it comes in. It's pretty basic, and then it does come with the chargers and stuff. It comes with wipes to clean it, the screen protector. I don't like the screen protector, I don't use those, but I have like all of this other stuff myself. But yeah, man, overall, I recommend this little handheld. It is hands down my favorite ever. Like, so for Sega Genesis, dude, I've been getting into the Sega more than I've always loved Super Nintendo. That's always been my favorite console. It's hard for me because I'm trying to show you guys in the video, but it's so hard for me to like actually play the game. But as you can see, like, ready? Boom, no delay, literally no delay at all. So yeah, man, overall, I recommend both of these. I'm blown away. This one specifically is just, it really does. But let me just kind of show you. So I showed you everything, but yeah, that's going to bring us to the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.